Are there any bones of a man found here? Do you suppose it was supposed to blow us up? Was your husband scared when he saw it? And many more along the same line thought, I'd like to see inside. And so would I. On Wednesday, my husband was in the room, and about 2 p.m., a large army truck with 6 men came, and the order was, back it up, and we'll load it. Who gave you the authority to move things? The answer was, the Frederickson. I said, who owns it? They didn't know. No, I said, it can't be moved until it's owned or until my husband gives permission. Then they called Frederickson, and later a call came from Moncton Army headquarters, stating they had service from the RCMP to remove it. I said, the RCMP weren't interested before. Why now? And after a few more questions, we decided to wait for Dave's permission. So, after the Nazi corporal blew his top, they left. Next day, Thursday, Dave was home in the afternoon when the RCMP and the army truck arrived to take the thing. They promised Dave that he would see the thing open and to be notified of its owner before loading. But after loading, no such promise was made. It was then government property. After much discussion, they left along with everything, including all the straps, ropes, wires, everything. Major Cullen called. He was very nice. On Friday, Dave went to have the CBC picture of it as he found it. Nothing happened until the news on Wednesday morning of its identification. And that is all.